Hey, what's up, guys, and welcome back to some more Call of Duty here on the channel. So today we're going to be talking about the brand new Season 3 update. I just wanted to share with you guys, Season 3 is officially coming out tonight or tomorrow early in the morning, depending on where you live. So normally, for as long as I can remember, Call of Duty updates their games on Tuesdays at 1 p.m. Eastern time, and I think it's 10 a.m. Pacific time or something like that. As of like the whole quarantine thing that's been going on for a couple of weeks now, some of the last updates have been a little bit different. Like, they've dropped at 1 or 2 a.m. in the morning for me. For instance, Season 3 officially comes out at 11 p.m. PT tonight. And I think that's like 1 or 2 in the morning for me. So things are a little bit different. In other news, we did get the Season 3 trailer officially released. And within this trailer, we've got a bunch of new things coming into multiplayer. And of course, we've also got some really cool things coming into Warzone. Now, the main thing, of course, as of with every single season, is a battle pass. We're going to be getting a brand new battle pass. Within that battle pass, we're going to have new things, new rewards, new unlockables, new blueprints or whatever. And of course, we're going to have a brand new weapons. Now, for multiplayer, there's going to be 2 brand new maps. And one of the maps that's actually going to be coming back is going to be a remake of Backlot from Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare. Now, the official name of Backlot within this game is actually called Talisk Backlot. And then we have another brand new map called the Havoc Sawmill. Now, this is a completely brand new, different map, never before seen. When it first got leaked, I think a lot of people were thinking that it was like a map from Modern Warfare 3 due to the layout or whatever, but it turned out to be a completely brand new, different map. Within Season 3, we also have a brand new sniper, and of course, we also got a brand new pistol. I just pray to God that the pistol's actually worth using, because pistols in this game are actually a little, you know, kind of trash. In addition to that, of course, as per every other season, we also have a brand new main operator named Alex. Warzone is going to be getting some brand new things, which, by the way, I am predicting that not everything is being shown within this trailer. I don't know if we're going to get brand new POIs. No, there's not going to be a brand new map like some people are actually talking about over on Twitter. I really highly doubt there's going to be a brand new map, but we are going to be getting some brand new weapons within Warzone, meaning like maybe some brand new default weapons, kind of like how when we got the EBR and when we got the 725, etc., etc. Not new weapons like weapons we've never seen before. Those would be for multiplayer and Warzone altogether, but I think we'll be getting new weapons for like just random loot around the map. I think the biggest two things within this update for Warzone are the brand new vehicles, because within the trailer you see a brand new ATV and a brand new truck. Now, are these really new vehicles? Like, is it really a brand new truck and a brand new ATV, or is it paint jobs? We just got breaking information as I'm recording this video. Here on screen, we got a roadmap of what's to come for Season 3. So for launch week, which is going to be as soon as this update drops, we're going to have Backlot, Havoc Sawmill, the Anaya Incursion, which is going to be, of course, for multiplayer. And then we're going to be getting a new Warzone game mode, which is Quads, which we already talked about. Confirmed vehicle skins and new weapons alongside with a brand new operator, which is Alex. On the right hand side, we have what's going to be coming within this season, which is going to be spread out throughout the entire season. We've got 2 brand new operators, Runnin and Iskra. Surprisingly enough, but not really, we have Hard Hat coming in as a new multiplayer map, and we also have IO9. There's also going to be a brand new weapon, which is classified at the moment. There's also going to be Gunsmith Customs, which that's going to be really interesting. And then, of course, we also have new Warzone content, such as scopes and scatter guns and more. And then, of course, new multiplayer modes, Gun Game Reloaded and Reinfected Ground War. I just want to say this roadmap for Season 3 is actually looking pretty damn promising. It looks like Season 3 is going to be jam-packed. I gotta say it again, man. I gotta give my hats up to I don't know if that makes any sense. I gotta give props to Call of Duty recently. They've been just throwing content, shitting content left to right, and it's been really, really consistent. And I honestly thought this was never gonna be a thing. Call of Duty's always been a game where it just dies immediately after like a week or two of the content dropping. But they've been so consistent with it as far as like just content every single week, whether it's just like new weapon variants or whatever. It's been a nice change of pace. Let me know what you guys think. What is your favorite part about this roadmap? Like, what do you like most about this update so far? Right. I am really digging the vehicle skins. I'm glad that the roadmap pretty much confirmed it for us. I'm also digging the fact that we're going to be getting Hard Hat. Hello, massive W. Now, what it's probably not going to be a W is going to be this gameplay. But, you know, this is Warzone. And in Warzone, we're meant to get triggered. This is what Battle Royale is all about. If you're not getting triggered in Warzone, then what are you even doing with your life? I give myself 5 minutes to stay alive. So count it down, starting like right now. This is gonna be a nightmare. I'll be honest, I'm happy that Squads is in here. I'm definitely going to be playing squads with some friends and family and shit like that. But I also feel like it's also going to be double the stress. I don't even know, but it's going to be more stressful than trios. Just remember when we had like squads in a BR map and then we suddenly just wanted trios because squads was a little bit too chaotic. This might just be the same scenario. I really do feel like this is going to be really, really stressful. Within the latest update, we had a thing within Warzone that it takes $8,500 to call in a loadout for trios or whatever. And now it kind of makes sense. Not just trios, but solos, just Warzone in general. Now it makes kind of sense, especially coming into squads now. I feel like within squads, you're going to be able to make money much, much quicker. I mean, playing in trios, you get money within less than a minute. You can get $8,500 if you land at the right spot. But when it comes to solos, it's a really, really, really tedious thing to do. Like right now, I've got $10,000. I don't even know how. I would assume I just got a really good spot and there's nobody here. I mean, it makes more sense if you have it on squads or whatever. Like totally, I completely get that. But in solos, it just never really made much sense to me. Maybe I'm just rambling. I feel like for solos, they should have kept it at the price that it was. I think it was 6,000 or something. But like anything above solos, I feel like 8,500 is perfectly fair. Wow, holy fucking. Oh, I don't got time for this, dude. Like, I'm sorry. I don't know if it's the sun hitting my ass, but I didn't fucking see that guy in there. Like, I'm sorry. I just really didn't see him. Oh no, I got the wrong one. You got gas moving in. Whether you believe it or not, I'm still not gonna give up because a lot of the games that I've won have been games that I've ended up going to the gulag right away and then I just end up coming back. Not saying that's the case, but I'm just sharing with you that it's still a possibility that we might get out of this alive.
All supply boxes found. Solid work. You've got gas moving in.
Really?
Enemy UAV overhead.
This is bad. I'm gonna die here. Oh, he died. What? Somebody killed him? Yeah, somebody did kill him. This guy killed him. This fucking guy killed him. That's who killed him. Oh, you're an absolute idiot.
Enemy UAV overhead.
You almost got me, bro. Holy crap.
Losing ground.
Oops. Let me not celebrate before it's too late. He did. Not even gonna worry about him. He should be dead.
Only 10 remain. Learn from the loss. Make this a proper teacher.
I refuse to believe that man just got up and lasered me like that. What the fucking shit was that? I am officially not letting anybody else live in this game. Nobody gets to live. Bitch. Fuck out of here with that. I also just realized I had dead silence and I didn't use it. Perfect.
Enemy personal radar in the air.
Got him. Oh shit. Got him. I think that's the same guy I killed, by the way. He probably came back. And I have to go back to the buying station and probably buy more shit. Yeah, he definitely came back. Came back for his loadout. Got him. I see somebody here. Yep, I fucking knew it.
You're losing ground.
fucking knew it. I knew he was gonna RPG that shit. That's what people do nowadays, bro. People just RPG everything. Or C4 everything. You know why? Because I do it myself. Yep.
Gas is closing in.
Got him. He did. He gone.
Enemy UAV overhead.
So is he.
You're losing ground.
I knew he was gonna watch me. Based on the shot that I got off that sniper. I knew that guy was gonna be peeking through that window.
Gas is closing. Get to the new safe zone. You gotta slot this bastard now.
How's that guy still alive, bro? Got it. Hoorah! Let's go, baby. All right, I'm done. Guys, thank you. Thank you very much. I will catch you on the next one.